Gautam and Zareen, welcome to Movie Talkies. You guys have said that Mercury is soaring. What kind of responses have you been getting?
As in, right now, all getting a good response out of everyone. But by the end of it, you got to tell us, because everyone who knows us, besides the family and close friends, everyone will say good things when we see us.
And what about you, Zareen?
It's been great. We have been getting a lot of appreciation for our promos, for our songs, which feels great. And I hope the appreciation continues in our film as well.
So the trailer looks very complicated. A lot of things are happening. Yeah. Is the film as complex?
Yes.
The film is complex, yeah.
It's a suspense. It's very complex.
Yeah, it's a suspense thriller. It's an intense mind game. So as in, and basically, if I say something as a little bit about the film, it's like we get an opportunity and everyone tries to avail that opportunity. But once you enter the game, then you realize that it's not what it looks like. And when you entered the situation, you thought that you are the only player, but out there everyone is playing a game. So willingly, unwillingly, for survival, everyone has to play the game, and in the end, let's see who comes out of it. So it's like that.
And how did this film happen to both of you, and what hooked you to the script?
Me, I was doing a show called Surya Putra Karan, the last one that I did on television. It was just getting over, so I got a call from Ananji, Mr. Ananth Mahadevan. He called me to the office, then I met the producers, Mr. Shyam Bajaj, Mr. Narendra Bajaj. They narrated me the script, they told me about my character, which I really liked, and they gave me a bound script. And it was something for me, it's always been like the kind of television work I've done. Also, it's always been different characters and different genres. So the ones that I've already done, it was different than the character that was offered to me. Then it had a good layering to it. Like it has his own positives, it has his grey shades, it has his flaws. So it's a multi-layered character. So that really enticed me into it, doing it.
And
so,
what about you, Sreen?
Aksar, the first one, was a successful film, you know. And to be a part of a successful franchise in itself is a great thing. Plus, the story of this movie is, you know, 10 times more interesting, more unpredictable than the previous one. This is, of course, a suspense thriller. And the thing that made me jump at the thought of doing this film was that I would be playing the female solo lead after a really long time, you know. So I think all these things made me make up my decision to do this film.
Like you said, that it's a very successful franchise and you guys are taking it forward. Are you feeling the pressure?
Not really.
Because it's not similar at all than the first one. Say the story, the screenplay, the actors, the technicians, the music director, everyone is different besides the director and the producer. They are the only people who are the same. And otherwise, there's nothing similar from the first. The tagline is also different. So that way, if you ask me or her, I don't think so. The pressure is not there, but it's just that we've done a film and it'll be out soon. So that excitement is there.
What about you? No pressure?
No, there's no pressure because, you know, we are already a part of a successful franchise. And the story, the script of this movie itself is very intriguing. So I'm sure, and after, you know, seeing the feedback that we've got for the promos and the songs, I think we're on the right track.
Okay, so you're very confident about this movie.
Yeah.
How did you prepare for your roles, respective roles, and do you relate to your characters?
Being from television, you usually do everything by yourself, as in terms of preparing the character and everything by yourself. So out here, in the beginning, we had only two workshops or two readings. I'll not exactly call them workshops, but they were readings of the script. And that also separately, I believe. So that also separately. So once I went to the set, it was already, I prepared myself. I have a habit to write my scenes in terms of, I think in Hindi. So I write it in Hindi and I prepare my character, my commas and how the character, it's visualized in my head. I always write it down. But once I reached the set, when I met Ananji on the set, then I told him that I've prepared like this, I've done this, I've done that. So he said, rubbish, I don't need anything out of it. So the 4 day, whatever you call the mehnat or mushakkat, it went for a toss. Then I started following him the way he wanted the character to be. The first few hours were a little tough because I came up with a different thought. and he had a different thing altogether, vision to it. But after 4-5 hours, it was all cool, and I'm glad and lucky that it was his vision that I followed in the film. So yes, that was your...
And do you relate to your character?
No, I don't. He's an opportunist, the character. He's diplomatic. He thinks about himself first all the time, and then anyone later. He has his own motives in mind. So nothing is relatable about the character and me in reality. So yes.
And how about you, Zareen? How did you prepare for the role?
I also did not really do any specific preparations for this character. I met Ananth sir a couple of times, and he just took me over the character over and over again to make me understand the character better, to make me in touch with the character. And that was it.
And you also had to overcome your fear of thalassophobia. That's what I read.
It's not a phobia. It's more of a creeped out feeling. You know, it's the seabed that kind of creeps me out, because in our country, our waters are not that clear. You don't really see the seabed, and there are sometimes you step on some things which you don't know what it is, and it's just an eerie feeling. And then we were shooting in Mauritius, and the waters are really clear there, and you can actually see everything on the seabed, and there's some weird creatures, though they look very beautiful, dur se, but I don't want to be around them. And so I was very, very careful as to, you know, my feet shouldn't touch any of those, and it's just... I just get creeped out. So,
and also because we are seeing you in a lot of swimsuits, so you must have done a lot of hard work there as well.
Oh, the whole song, the whole of Jana Ve has been shot on the beach, and where, you know, I'm supposed to look, you know, all in love, and this typical Hindi film heroine where her clothes are flying and she's enjoying running here and there. But I was very scared doing that in that water.
So a lot of hard work went into that part as well. So do you relate to your character?
No, I don't. I don't.
You don't relate to our characters.
So Gautam, this character that you are playing is a far cry from what we've earlier seen you doing. Were there any apprehensions?
When I picked it up, no, because I always want to do something different. So when it came to me, it had a lot of layering. The character had a lot of layering. I've never done such a thing before. The roles that I've done on television, they are all different genres, different characters, but they are all on the positive side. So this one, if I see, I'll not call it negative, but he has his positivity in a way. He has his gray shades in a way. He has his flaws. He, somewhere down the line, he thinks that he's a player, but later on it comes out something else. He's getting played at the same time. So there were many things to it. So it was not one layer that I just follow. For that matter, I think about her also. So it's
everybody is very complex. Is a player and is getting played at the same time, you know. So
in a way, yes. So in the beginning, someone thinks that, oh, he's the boss. Then second moment, someone thinks that she's the boss. So it's just going on. It's going on in the film.
Okay, you guys have several intimate scenes as well, no?
No.
Not at all.
One song is there.
That's what
in which we haven't even kissed, so we can't call it intimate.
Yeah, so there's no kissing, and that was a deliberate decision. See, the song was so sensuous in itself. See, the lighting did the trick in the song. The most important part is the lighting. Choreography, definitely. Shabina did a good job out of it. But at the same time, according to me, the boss of the song is the lighting. And we, as actors and the makers and the director, we were all on the same page that we didn't have to cross a certain line. So there's a difference between sensuality and vulgarity. And we didn't want to kind of get into that zone, because it's a very sensuous song. If we would have done a little bit more out of it, it would have been shown and talked about in a different way. So that's why that was a deliberate decision, definitely by the actors.
And also, it's a very situational song. Yeah. Like when you see the movie, you'll understand why it's happening. Yeah. You know, so you can't unnecessarily be doing things and adding things just to spice up something. I think what we've done is more than enough in it. And if you see, it's just shot in a very sensuous manner. I am fully clothed. I am, you know, there's not a lot of skin show happening. We've not even kissed in that song, but it still looks sensuous.
Yeah, and it's very important to the film, like she rightly said. It's very important to the film. That's I can say that can be the turning point of the film as well. So that particular moment, and we've put, as in, we've shot the song in a way, we have our, we had our things, ki, oh, it can go overboard.
Yeah.
So that was a deliberate thing from our side, but it had to be there. We couldn't just eliminate the song and we couldn't make it a romantic number because it's not a romantic number. The situation is not such. So yeah.
You are doing this film after Hate Story,
yes.
Okay. So is it a conscious decision to be a part of thrillers which are also bold for an image shift?
No, it's not actually. I mean, there is, even when I did Hate Story, it wasn't a conscious effort. It was a chance that I took because I myself wasn't sure whether my fans are going to be liking this or not liking this. But luckily, I got appreciated and a lot of new doors opened for me. And maybe, you know, because this film is also a thriller. It's not a, it's, this film is not an erotic film. Hate Story was an erotic genre. This is not an erotic film. It's a love story. And if you see, I think, you know, now I am bold because there were certain things that I did in Hate Story which people have never seen me do before. But, and now, when people talk, it's a ripple effect of Hate Story 3. But when you see this, when you compare this movie and Hate Story, there is a huge difference. Like, you know, whatever scenes that has been done here is with my love interest, where I'm showing love to this one person that I'm in love with. I am almost fully clothed most of the time. Yes, Janave, I am on the beach, but I'm still not in a bikini. I am wearing denim shorts and I'm wearing like this long gown on top of it. But I'm still called bold and whatever names, God knows what. I will take it as a compliment because for the longest I wasn't called these names and called all the bad names possible.
All right, so the censor chief has changed. Are you happy about it?
Let's see here.
I don't know.
We really got to see, the rules are the same. So the policies are the same. So I don't know. I hope that it goes in every filmmaker's way in terms of everyone's interest. But we have to change the rules and the policies. Then only the changes can happen. Otherwise, it'll be the same. It'll be the same effect. I think so.
What about you?
I honestly can't comment on this because Palaji was the, you know, head of censorship when Hate Story had come out. And we did not really get many cuts there. And this movie doesn't even have half of what we were doing in Hate Story. So I don't know. Let's see.
Okay. So, film mein ek dialogue hai ki agar aap kisi se pyar karte hain, to aap uske liye aisa kuch karenge jisse wo aapse kabhi dobara pyar na kare. So, will you do that ever in your life? Will you take that chance?
See, if it's very important for my loved one, and it's a dire situation where it's do or die, then yes. But I at the same time wish and hope that my loved one understands that I'm doing that thing for her. So I just hope and pray for that if I get into a situation like this ever. Yes.
What about you?
Same, you know, because it's a very it's kind of an affix that you get yourself into when something like this happens. And at that time, you really want to do something for your loved one. And you really wish that the person understands that whatever you're doing at that point, however good or bad it is for their betterment. And I think it actually depends on what situation it is. And I think I will take the chance. Not what I have done in this movie, but otherwise I would take a chance depending on what situation it is.
Have you ever lied to get a job?
Lied to get a job? No.
Right. No.
What is the weirdest condition that has been told to you to fulfill while getting a project or a job?
There have been many, to be, if you ask me. There have been very stupid ones. I can't name it on camera.
But yeah. Quote a few.
I can't quote them, man. They were bad. But they are weird ones, as in which doesn't go with your value system and ethics. So there are certain ones that you just want to avoid and say, hey, boss, not my cup of tea, I'm really sorry. And I'm okay not getting the job. So it's certain things were like that have come to me. But
once or twice.
Weirdest one did I get? I honestly can't say it on camera. The weirdest one I got.
So, yes. Okay, not so weird one. Anyone. You know,
any
which
particular
is
one?
Not that, very controversial.
Which is not very controversial. See, it all depends on your, see, my thing is more of value system. If it goes with me, it goes with my mindset and all that. If someone, as in, tries I'll not say that'll be weird, but in a way where the other person is just taking me for granted or just taking me for a ride, and I know that the other person is just showing their bossiness, boss, okay, fine, this is me, if you want to take it, you got to work my way. So my thing is, I need to work respectably. I can't just be bullied around. So maybe one, two things have happened like that, where I've stepped back and say, thank you very much, I don't want the job.
And how about you, Zareen?
Luckily, I haven't
no weird conditions
anything,
ever. No. All right. While doing a project, have you ever felt trapped?
No.
क्या बोलूँ?
नहीं. No. No. Give us an answer. You are trapping other people in the film now.
Yeah, it's, this one is a different thing altogether. But yeah, certain times you, once you are in a project, you can't name the projects. We can't. It's not respectable. But yeah, sometimes you do feel that. To be very honest, brutally honest, you feel that boss. The way it's going, it shouldn't go the way that, and this was not that we were told that it will be, and we try and control ourselves there, control our emotions, we get angry, we get upset, but once you're there, you just can't leave
it. Yeah, you just want to like get done with it and
get done
leave.
With it and just, because see, as in, I can vouch for her also because I know her now. So we can't leave one work, as in terms of one's work, and just say we can't do it. This is not
that's
us.
That's a commitment.
Because
that
it's
you
a commitment
to
we want to fulfill. Maybe we'll get angry, we'll get upset, but
we try to get
it.
A middle way out of it. You
we
know?
Try. Sometimes it happens, sometimes it doesn't. But our duty as actors, we want to fulfill our commitments, finish the job, and move on. So that's what.
Same as with you.
Same.
Okay. How was it working with Ananth Mahadevan?
Very good. Like I told you, what happened with me in the beginning, where I prepared the character myself, and he had a different vision altogether to it. And from there on, he just held the characters really well. He's very good at it. He's very good at his job, especially the performances. Really take care of the sur, the eyes. With me, he had a constant thing. Yaar, teri aankhe waisi theek thaak si badi si hain. Don't open them so much. Thoda thoda control, thoda kam, thoda kam. So he had this with me in terms of every frame or everything. Gautam, itni badi aankhe nahi karni. Aaj kuch aur meaning nikalta. So he's a good actor himself. And he's worked in all kind of, in terms of theatre, television, films, he's done everything possible. So he's got that kind of experience. So his experience really helped me and us, I believe, in the film, yes.
How was your experience?
It was great because, you know, he comes from a theatre background, and when you come from a theatre background, you're very good at a lot of things. Like, he himself is a very good actor, his diction is really good. So he is very clear as to how he wants each and every character of his, as he just said. Mm-hmm. So, you know, from the behavior of that character, how he wants to portray that character, how he wants the character to sound. So he was just very clear of all of it, and I think that was a real great help.
Mm. Okay. So how is this film different from other thrillers? What sets it apart?
See, honestly, we can't just talk very, very well, as in we should talk about our film, but it's an entertaining film. It has its twists and turns in it. It's got a very good plot to it. The content is really good. The writing is excellent. And it's a compact film. It's not a lengthy film. It's not a stretched film. So these are the benefits. But we can't compare it. And I don't want to kind of say that it's better than these films. Every film is good in its own way. That everyone is working hard towards it. So we've worked hard towards a project in a film. And we just hope it clicks.
And Zareen, what according to you is the USP of this film?
The script. Yeah. We have a very strong script. You know, we watch a lot of thrillers. Sometimes it gets very predictable, but this one is a very unpredictable thriller. It will keep the audiences on their toes till the end. They'll keep guessing till the end as to, you know,
who's
the culprit and what's going to happen. So I think that is the USP, that the audiences won't get bored. They won't be able to predict.
All right. Tell our audiences quickly why they should watch Aksar 2.
Boy, I just said. Okay, fine. That's the camera for me. Hello. See, it's again a content-driven film. It's a good-looking film. The locations are excellent. You'll see some decent performances. The songs are really nice. It's a well-directed film. Production values are also good. And we shot in Mauritius. And rest, she'll say.
Hi guys, Aksar 2 releases on the 6th of October. So please go and watch the movie. I'm sure you guys won't be disappointed. You'll have already given a lot of love to the promo and the songs, and I'm sure the movie is not going to disappoint you.
Gautam and Zareen, it was great talking to you. I wish you all the best
for
Aksar 2.
Thank you.